Hi, I'm Rick Usey, Vice President of Marketing at ZCorum. I'm here with Peter Olivier, our Vice President of Systems, and we're here to talk today about DPoE and DPoG. That's DOCSIS provisioning over EPON and DOCSIS provisioning over GPON. So, Pete, we're starting to hear a lot more about this. Providers are asking more about it. What's going on?
So what's happening is a lot of people are trying to decide what they want to do for future technology. They're getting a lot of pressure from increase in bandwidth. The new 4K and 8K devices, TVs that are out there, are creating these high bandwidth streams, and you could, you know, a couple streams, and you can easily be upwards of 100 megabits per second. So what operators are trying to do is figure out, how can I compete with the U-verses and Googles that are coming into my backyard? Do I go DOCSIS 3.1? Do I go fiber? And there are some questions around, you know, decisions that have to be made. And one of the options is, you know, as part of those solutions is DPO, you know, DOCSIS provisioning of GPON or DOCSIS provisioning of EPON.
So what's the advantage of provisioning a fiber device using DOCSIS versus how they would normally do it?
Okay, so if it was going to come in straight into fiber, I've got to buy infrastructure, provisioning systems. I have to train all my staff on the new way to provision everything. This allows you to leverage your existing DOCSIS provisioning systems and infrastructure, and your people already are familiar with that. It's a quicker way to get into the fiber space without having to make major changes or investments of money.
So how does that work? How do you provision a fiber device using DOCSIS?
Okay, so the DPoE, DPoG standard was put in place so that you could provision GPON and EPON as if it were DOCSIS. So the OLT will look like a CMTS to the provisioning system. An ONT, ONU will look like a cable modem to the provisioning system. There's an emulation layer that goes in between that takes the fiber language and puts it in the DOCSIS language, and then in reverse it goes back.
Okay. So do they, if they're going to do this, do they need any special equipment or software?
Yeah, most of the vendors out there will have a DPoG or DPoE solution based on what technology they've chosen as their preferred technology. But they will have a system that will provide that, and usually it could be a virtual machine or a physical system or something like that, that they can provide. Because what they want is they want the cable operators, the DOCSIS operators, to move into the fiber space. They're trying to make it as easy as possible and provide that emulation layer, to make it work for them so they can get them to come over.
Is there a difference between DPoE and DPoG as far as the provisioning side?
Not on the provisioning side so much. It's just the EPON standard and the GPON standard were for two different standards organizations. One was ITU, one was IEEE. EPON kind of took over in Asia because a lot of the vendors were already over there. GPON has probably a bigger footprint right now, if you go look. But it mostly is in North America. You see a lot of DPoG capability here in the States and in North America.
Okay. So if you can do this emulation with a CMTS or the fiber equipment looking like CMTS and a cable modem, and you can do that emulation, can you actually get diagnostics the way you would from a DOCSIS device?
No, you can get some. It's not a full emulation. It's kind of a limited emulation so that you could do provisioning. That was what the standard was for. But it does have some things in there that you could go get some basic SNMP information. You can get some IPDR data and things like that out of it. But really, our applications and services we do, we like to dig deeper and have a much wider breadth of information coming out of the system. So we actually talk directly to the OLTs and in some cases the ONTs on use to get the detailed information. And that's probably a better method. It gives you more information to work with.
Okay, great. That's great information. Thanks, Pete. So, of course, we provide managed services for broadband providers, and one of the things that we do is provisioning. And we can provision DOCSIS, fiber, and DPoE, DPoG. So if you need that, just give us a call at 800-909-9441.